This MMA 30 segment is powered by The Gun Store. Next time you're in Las Vegas, if you want to shoot a real machine gun, do it at The Gun Store at 2900 East Tropicana.
Of course, my prediction is going to be Guida. He's my teammate, training buddy. I was able to help him prepare for this fight. Pettis is a good friend of mine too, but I mean, it's a fight business, and you always want to go with your teammates. So I definitely got to go with Clay on this. I'm hoping Clay knockout or submission first round. Me personally, I'm okay with either guy winning. It doesn't matter. I hope to fight both of those guys one day, you know, whether it's for the title or not for the title. They're definitely two good opponents. So me personally, if I had to say what would be the easiest pick for me to take the belt, I would say Frankie Edgar. I probably have a better chance, an easier chance of beating Frankie than Gray. I'll beat both of them, but I think my chances will be a lot easier with Frankie. I'm right around the corner from a title shot. Just as soon as they offer me the chance, the opportunity, I'll be ready. I've been in this sport 15 years, and I've trained hard up until this point for that, you know, and right now it's all about the title. So the minute I get the call, I'm be ready. Like right now, I'm already mentally ready. I just have to put myself in physical shape once I get that phone call. There's still a lot to get from me. Coach Winklejohn, I work with him night and day. He's my striking coach up at Jackson's. He doesn't get a lot of recognition that he should, but he's really one of the men behind the master plan, you know, behind my success. Me and Coach Greg, we also have our things that we work on, but I work more with Coach Winklejohn than I do Greg. And right now I'm putting together a lot of different techniques of striking, always being creative, always trying to reinvent the wheel, per se. So that's pretty much how my training sessions are. I'm always thinking, like, I go to sleep, I wake up thinking about a new way of striking, something, you know, a different combo. So right now I'm definitely evolving, definitely getting better, but there's still a lot more in the magic chest that I gotta bring out. So there's definitely, you guys, I gotta try to top that Pettis kick off the cage. So I'm still working on some things. I'm always looking for TKO. Like, that's just the way I fight. I like to make, there's a thing in fighting, you have good fighters and you have great fighters. I'm like right on the cusp of a great fighter, meaning that I'm one of those fighters. There's a little section of fighters that are highlight fighters. I'm one of those fighters. I make highlights. So I'm definitely looking to make a highlight out of Shane Roller on July 2nd. And it's definitely going to be fight of the night or knockout of the night. Well, technically, probably knockout of the night. You know, the fight of the night means you got to fight a little bit too hard to make that extra money. But definitely knockout of the night. I like easy money. I think Gilbert is going to be a great asset to the UFC if he comes over. He's definitely a worthy opponent. I know when Dana and them first brought the company, I called Dana right away. I was at Daytona Bike Week watching the races. And when I saw the news, I immediately called Dana and asked for that Gilbert Melendez fight. You know, they always appreciate my enthusiasm. Like, I'm one of those fighters, I don't sit around and wait for a phone call. I'm more proactive. Like, I want to fight the best guys. And I called Dana. He was like, kid, that's not going to happen right now because, you know, we still have to fulfill all the Strikeforce contracts. So I was kind of bummed out. But, you know, in due time, you know, all the fights that I asked for will come. You know, I still want the Jim Miller fight. It's a lot of guys I want to fight that I know will put me in title contention. So right now, you know, I feel I'm the best 155er, so I want to fight the best. And if Gilbert comes over to the UFC, then I want to fight him. If not, if I got to visit the Strikeforce just to go get some hands with, trade hands with Gilbert, then hopefully they'll let that happen too. So we'll see what happens.